behind Styx in 1975. Big power ballads. It was big rock and roll.
In the very beginning, we were five naive young men from the south side of Chicago who were damn excited to come to A&M.
The first time I met Jerry Moss, he shook my hand, and I thought, oh my God, they've hired Charlton Heston to pretend that he's Jerry Moss.
You know, I remember we would put really interesting album covers out for them.
The art department at A&M was second to none, and they came up with this idea of a block of ice on fire.
Equinox was one of my favorite Styx albums, and for that album with that much good music on it to have this kind of an album cover.
Thought we were going to have a big smash record in 1976 with our second record, Crystal Ball, but Frampton had Frampton Comes Alive that year, and we were opening for Peter at that point in time because that record had started to really sell. But then the very next year we got ours with Grand Illusion. Grand Illusion sold 6 million copies.
There Are Moments was incredible. I never thought it would get this big.
A&M knew that we needed to develop an artist, and they gave us the tools, and we felt nurtured there.
There was this freedom that we had, you know, and we took full advantage of it.
Because of A&M's lasting belief in us, we were able to record 3 more triple platinum albums consecutively.
Styx was one of the first airplane groups. In other words, we finally had an act that actually could fly on their own private plane. Wow.